Hey guys, welcome back to Serial at Midnight. My name's Heath Holland, and I've got a quick Ghostbusters Frozen Empire review for you. I'm going to keep this short, sweet. I'm also going to keep this relatively spoiler-free, but listen, there's a few things we got to talk about here that may venture into some light spoiler territory, but I bet if you've seen the trailer, you'll be okay. Also, the movie's out, so you could just go see it and then watch this video. Here's what you need to know. I love the first Ghostbusters movie. 1984, perfect movie. Lightning in a bottle. And here's the thing. They're never going to recapture that. And I wish they'd stop trying, because you can't recapture lightning in a bottle. And every trip back to that well has been a little bit, sometimes not a little bit, sometimes a lot diminished. Ghostbusters 2, it's not as good as Ghostbusters 1, in my opinion. The all-female Ghostbusters movie, it's not Ghostbusters, it's something else. We already have a Ghostbusters that millions of people all over the planet love and connect with. Dogs and cats living together. Like, no, we already have that. Do something new. So then they're like, okay, we'll do Ghostbusters Afterlife. How about that? I reviewed Ghostbusters Afterlife right here, blong, on the channel. And you should watch that review, because I got a lot to say about it. But my joke is, it should have been called, hey, remember the Ghostbusters? Because it's almost like an apology for the previous Ghostbusters attempt. And it really just reheats a lot of stuff from the first Ghostbusters movie, right? Like the whole back half of the movie is just the first Ghostbusters movie put in a blender, reserved like it's hot, but it's not hot. Like it's hot, but it's not, right? So I was trepidatious about Ghostbusters Frozen Empire because I was like, they didn't win me over the last time. They just served me up Ghostbusters that I already had. They just reminded me why. Like, when I got home from Ghostbusters Afterlife, I just wanted to go watch Ghostbusters, which I think I did, actually. So, listen, they're making these movies, right? So, I can shake my fist at them and I could go, I'll curse you for making these Ghostbusters movies. Or I can go see them and see how they stand up as films. So, Ghostbusters Frozen Empire, on the surface, to me, is a much better movie than Ghostbusters Afterlife. It stands alone in the sense of, like, we don't have it. It's not an origin story. We've already done the origin story. Like, there's these kids. Now they're Ghostbusters, which for me is problematic. Children as Ghostbusters. This movie, the first Ghostbuster movie, is not a children's movie. There's stories about the making of Ghostbusters. Those comedians, the 1980s, wild times. Kids can watch it. It's not just for kids, right? There are no children Ghostbusters in that movie. This movie does stand a little bit more on its own on the surface. Then you start to think about it. But, well, first of all, because they're back in New York, right? Well, we got New York. We've got the firehouse. We got Janine. Janine gets to do something cool at the end of the movie, too, which I was really excited about because I freaking love Janine. We got basically everything we could ever want as far as, like, legacy stuff. Dan Aykroyd is a fairly large presence in the movie. But here's the thing. When you start thinking about it, it's just Ghostbusters reheated. It's all... Okay, so what if the containment trap, what if that malfunctions and all the ghosts get out? Like in the first movie, remember? What if there's a god who is released on Earth and the Ghostbusters have to fight him? Like in the first movie. What if there's like a chosen one who has control over an element? Not a key master, maybe a flame master, like a fire guy? Kind of like in the first movie, right? It's all these elements that we already know, and that's why people connect with it. Let's be clear. This is invisible movie language for shortcuts to your nostalgia center. That's what they're doing. That's what the filmmakers have done. They've bypassed things like traditional character development and just leaned on the things that we already know and that we already love, and they've put a new veneer on them. They put a new mask on them, and it feels a little bit fresh, but then you start thinking about it, and you're like, oh no, this is exactly the thing we already had. So these movies are not going to age well, okay? You're going to, like, I heard from, people talk about the first one, they're like, oh, I was bawling. It's like, I wonder how you're going to feel about that when you marathon all of the Ghostbusters and you get to that fourth Ghostbusters movie and you're like, this is a lot like the first one. And now we have this new one. And people are going to go, well, it's an echo, right? And because I'm all about echoes. I talk about echoes constantly. There's a stone, and then there's the ripples from the stone. All of these things are echoes of a stone that landed 40 years ago. Now, the Star Wars movies tried to do this. The Indiana Jones movies tried to do this. You try to recapture the feeling that thing originally had. And so all these years later, they're trying to introduce a new generation to Ghostbusters by calling back the stuff that we already love. Hey, if you're going to go to the New York Library, you know what's there. Slimer's in the movie, which I'm super happy about because I love Slimer. Here's the thing. Like, I don't love this movie. I also don't really dislike this movie. This movie's fine. It's fine. But as soon as you realize all the shortcuts that are being taken with the storytelling, you're like, well, wait a minute. Why couldn't we do something that's really original? Listen, the Sony as a studio, just Hollywood in general, has been trying to figure out a way to franchise these things that really, it's one movie, right? It's one really successful movie that they just keep trying. And our nostalgia is strong enough that we go, you know what? I had a good time. I'm looking for something that's going to stand the test of time, that's really going to give me something new that I haven't had before. This movie does do a few things. I like Kumail Nanjiani's character in this movie. I like the idea of the spirit world mingling with the physical world. I'm not sure how I feel about the execution of it. It's great to have all of our surviving Ghostbusters back. It's a fun movie. It's a good party movie. If you love Ghostbusters, if you're cosplaying as a Ghostbuster, if you're hitting up the convention scene, if you have the toys, this movie's going to make you happy. But it could have been better. And it should have been better. In a world where we're just going to keep having Ghostbusters movies, by the way, they set up another Ghostbusters movie where they're just going out and tracking down ghosts, kind of like in the first movie, right? We just keep going back to the first movie. If you really want to impress me, take us into territory we've never been before. We don't need an analog for Egon. We don't need a little Egon. Give us something we haven't had before. Or you could just leave it alone and let us bask in the glow of that perfect first movie. But we all know that's not going to happen. So that's my thoughts on Ghostbusters Frozen Empire. It's fine. Could have been great. If you have thoughts about it, and I'm sure you do, let's continue the conversation in the comments below. Listen, be very respectful because everybody, like, people, when nostalgia gets involved, people get real itchy. They start to get, like, you're not talking about a movie. You're talking about their childhood. So I try to be really careful with that. I love Ghostbusters, right? I wanted more from this. That's all I'm saying. Let's continue the conversation. Guys, thumbs up, subscribe. Do you want more short reviews for new movies like this? If you do, let me know in the comments below. Also, subscribe to this channel so you never miss one of my new videos. Guys, thank you so much. I appreciate you. Take care. Till next time, I will catch you later.